He was the kind of friend, the kind of mentor, the kind of executive, the kind of visionary that all of us should aspire to be. He did that. My only wish is that we could have given him his flowers while he was here. Our hearts are heavy right now. We just got the news that Andre Harrell has passed away at 59 years old. Andre Harrell meant so much to so many people, and this loss is honestly devastating. As a music figure, Andre Harrell has had perhaps the most influential impact on our culture in the last three decades. He starts off as an artist, as part of Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. He had songs like Genius Rap. Some of the old heads know that music really well. And then he becomes an executive. He meets Russell Simmons, and he instantly becomes a sensation at Def Jam. And after 2 years, he becomes an executive, and people see his genius, and he's helping to birth some of the most important artists we've seen. And then he gets his own label deal at Uptown Records, and that's when you really see him shine. You can't talk about Heavy D, you can't talk about Jodeci, you can't talk about Mary J. Blige, you can't talk about Albie Shore, you can't talk about Puffy without talking about Andre Harrell. He is somebody who had the vision to put black culture on the main stage, but on his terms. When you hear the term ghetto fabulous in all of its best sense, that's what Andre Harrell dreamed of, showing black people from the hood. Remember, he's from uptown. Brothers from the hood, sisters from the hood, who have all that ghetto flavor, but also have taste, also have judgment, also have talent. He put all that together, and that's how you get something like Uptown Unplugged. I mean, what other record label got its own TV special? Only Andre Harrell could think of something like that. And it wasn't just music. He had deals in multimedia. So you had stuff like New York Undercover. It wasn't just TV. Shows like New York Undercover had Andre Harrell all over it. So our urban flavor, our urban style, the whole world got to see it, but on our terms, because of people like Andre Harrell. He goes over and revives Motown Records. That's what he was able to do. He was able to take something and fix it based on his visionary nature. He didn't just try to go with the flow. Andre Harrell created the flow. That's what made him a visionary. Now over at Revolt, you see him pushing music festivals. You see him advancing and breaking new talent on air and in the music booth. Andre Harrell understood how to push the culture forward. He respected the culture. He loved the culture. He protected the culture, and he always did it with integrity. But Andre Harrell wasn't just an executive. He wasn't just somebody who wanted to be great. He was also somebody who wanted to be good. There's a lot of people in this business that have been around for three decades, and people got all kinds of stuff to say about him. But I have never heard a bad word about Andre Harrell. All I see is people talking about how wonderful he was, how loyal he was, how generous he was. And I experienced that for myself. I first met Andre Harrell about 10 years ago at Our World with Black Enterprise I was hosting. And when I came in the room, it was all love. Some people don't talk to you. Some people are aloof. Some people were staring at their Blackberries back in the day, acting like they were too cool to talk to you. Nah, he was like, brother, I know who you are and I respect what you do. And then he gave me advice. He gave me tips. And he gave me 45 minutes for an interview that was only supposed to be 10 minutes. That's how generous he was. After the interview, he gave me his info. He said, if you ever need anything, I got you. And he also gave me more advice, more support. He puts that battery in your back so that you can be great. Some people just want to shine for themselves. Andre Harrell was at his best when he was making other people shine, when he was putting other people on the main stage, when he was letting other people ascend to the top. He wanted to create jobs. He didn't just want to build up wealth for himself. He wanted to create more stars, not just to become the center of attention. He was the kind of friend, the kind of mentor, the kind of executive, the kind of visionary that all of us should aspire to be. He did that. My only wish is that we could have given him his flowers while he was here, but we're gonna give it to him now. Everybody, make sure you show the love you had for Andre Harrell. Post it on social media. Write essays about it. Make films about it. He's somebody who cannot be buried in history. He's somebody we need to know was a pioneer of our culture. And in this current moment, send love to his family. Send love to his beloved son. Send love to all the people who cared about him. Andre Harrell, you were a giant. You were a legend. You were a friend. You were a mentor to so many people. We are grateful for you. God bless your life. Rest in peace. Rest in power.